Hello friends, welcome to Efficient Learning World. So in this video, I am going to explain you about the program to find factorial of number using the recursion. So in the previous video, I explained you about recursion, recursion types, recursion examples, and program to find power of any number using the recursion. Now this is the program to find the factorial of number using the recursion. Okay, so I have already explained the program to find factorial of any number in my C++ program playlist. You can check it on the playlist, but this is the recursion playlist. So I am going to explain program to find factorial using the recursion. So recursion technique will be used to find the factorial. So first see what is the factorial. So factorial of n is the product of all the positive descending integers. For example, this is an example. A factorial of n is represented by n factorial. And for example, if I want to calculate the factorial of 4, so 4 factorial will be represented by this. And to find the factorial of 4, I have to multiply all the positive descending integers below the 4 until 1. So 4, 3, 2, 1. And I will multiply each digit. Okay, and the product will be the factorial of this number. So 4 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 1 is equal to 24. So 24 is the factorial of this number. See another example. For example, if I want to calculate the factorial of 6, so 6 factorial will be represented by this exclamation symbol, and 6 factorial is equal to 6 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 1 is equal to 720. Okay, so it means that factorial of the n is product of all positive descending integers from that number until we reach 0. Okay, and all integers we have to multiply, and the answer will be the factorial of that number. So for example, another example, factorial of 1. If I am saying that I want to calculate factorial of 1, okay, so I can represent it like this. If I am representing it in function form, like function, user defined function we have in C and C++ or in Python, then I can represent it just fact and brackets the value about which I have to find the factorial. Okay, so factorial 1 is equal to factorial 1. For example, if I want to calculate the 2, the factorial of 2, then I just have to pass that number in this function, and this will calculate the factorial. So this means that 2 multiplied by 1. Okay, so this is a product of all descending number from 2 until we reach 1. So 2 multiplied by 1. So I can represent this 2 multiplied by fact 1. Why 1? Because 1 is equal to factorial 1, because factorial of 1 will also be 1. Another example, factorial 3. If I want to find the factorial of 3, so it means that 3 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 1. So I can say that this 2 multiplied by 1 is the same part as we have in the factorial of 2. So it means I can replace it just by 2 factorial, means 3 multiplied by 2 factorial. If I will calculate the factorial of 2, then I just have to multiply factorial of 2 multiplied by 3, and I will get my answer, that will be 6. So another example, factorial 4. So factorial 4 is equal to 4 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 1. So again, this is something which is common in factorial 3 and factorial 4. What is that thing is 3 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 1 is the same as we have in the factorial 3. So I can represent it just by factorial 3. And if I just have to calculate the factorial 3, and whatever the answer will be, for example, factorial of 3 is 6. Okay, so 6 will be replaced by this factorial, and if I will multiply 6 multiplied by 4, then answer will be 24, and 24 will be the factorial of 4, as I have already explained you earlier. Okay, so you can also say that you can also replace this part is also common in factorial 2, and you can write thus just 4 multiplied by 3 multiplied by factorial 2. That will also be correct, but I am saying for the convenience and easily that if I want to calculate 4, then the factorial of 4, then 4 multiplied by 1 minus that descendant, and I have to multiply that number with its factorial. Okay, so if I want to calculate for n numbers, for n time, for example 61, if I want to calculate the factorial of 61 or 71 or 100, then for n number I can just write this that function. Okay, the function which will calculate the factorial, and it will return answer. So this will be like function. Okay, and this is the value which I want to calculate the factorial, and that function will be remain same and multiply by n minus 1. Why this is n minus 1? As I have already explained you in this, that 4, if I want to calculate 4 factorial of 4, then I just have to multiply by 4 multiply by its descendant number factorial. For example, 4 multiplied by 3 factorial. If I want to calculate 3 factorial of 3, then it means then I just have to write 3 multiplied by factorial of 2. So whatever the answer of factorial 2, that will be multiplied by 3. Whatever the answer will be factorial of 3, that will be multiplied by 4. And answer will be again the same. So this is the general formula. If you have studied in your mathematics or bachelor's, you will know that this is the general formula of finding the factorial. Okay, so I just have you can say implement or prove this formula in this slide. Okay, so if you don't know how this formula is proved, so this is actually the you can say this is the proof of this formula. Okay, so n factorial is equal to n multiplied by n minus 1 until 1, but this whole part can be replaced just by this exclamation symbol, that is finding the factorial. Okay, so whatever the number you find to find factorial, for example, if I have to calculate the factorial of 5, then I just have to write here 5 multiplied by 5 minus 1, 4. So 5 multiplied by 4 factorial, the answer will be again whatever, for example, 120 will be the answer of the factorial 4. So let's again take another example. For example, if I have to calculate factorial of 4, then I can say that 4 multiplied by 4 minus 1. Okay, if I put this number in this formula, okay, so this formula so this will be like 4 multiplied by 4 minus 1. Okay, so this is same as it. Okay, and this will be 3, and again the 3 factorial can be put in this formula, and this will be like 3 multiplied by 3 minus 1. So this will be like this. Again, 3 minus 1, 2. So if I put this 2 in this formula, then this will be like 2 multiplied by 2 minus 1, like this. Again, 2 minus 1, 1, and 1 factorial, this. And 1 minus 1 will be 0. So we know that the factorial of 0 is always 1. So 1 multiplied by 1, 1. 1 multiplied 1 will be returned by this. It means that factorial of 1 is 1. Okay, so I can replace this just by 1. So 2 multiplied by 1, 2, and 2, and I can say that the factorial of 2 is 2, and the it will be like 6, and the factorial of 3 is 6. Okay, so 6, and 6 multiplied by 4, just answer is 24. So this is the factorial of 24. So why I am explaining you the examples of so much examples of this, because I want to find the pseudo code of to find the factorial using the recursion. So see, this is the simplest form, this is the simplest pseudo code of the finding factorial. Okay, so this is the same function as I have taken in my example, that the this is the user defined function, let's suppose. Okay, so you can also write here any name whatever you want, for example factorial, finding factorial f only. Okay, so I just use a declare a factorial, that is my you can say user defined function, and it will receive the argument whatever I will pass here for value. For example, if I want to calculate the factorial of 4, then I just have to pass here 4, and the 4 will be stored in this variable, that will be n. Okay, then this is the function body. Okay, so whatever the code will be written in this function body will be executed and answer will be returned. Okay, so this is n. Okay, so this is same as I have already explained you until 1, we just have to recall the function again and again. Okay, so this is the same example I have explained you. Okay, so this is the same example. Okay, so this is just the pseudo code. So if you are not getting this pseudo code, so don't worry, I will explain you the dry run of this pseudocode. So for example, let's see, this is the basically the C++ or C implementation pseudocode of this implementation, but you can also use this implementation in you can say Python. The concept will be same. Okay, so this is just a user defined function that will receive the value which I have to find factorial. Okay, and this will whatever the body will be, this will be calculated and this will return the my answer, and this is the main function. So if, for example, if I want to calculate factorial of 4, then I will have to just declare a variable or initialize, or also I can take input from the user like cin. Okay, and then taking input from the user, and then I just have to call the function that will calculate the factorial, and that answer will be returned here like this, and this will be printed on console like factorial of 4 is 24 or factorial of 3 is 6. Okay, whatever. Now the code or the coding will be like this. this is the you can say this is the function that will calculate the factorial, and this is the base condition, and this is the else part that will hold again it's the function again and again. That's why this is a recursive function. Okay, so let's try run this code. So for example, this is my function, okay, and this is the main function. This is user defined function that will calculate the factorial, and this is the main function. So first of all, for example, I want to calculate the factorial of 4, then I just have to declare a variable, initialize a variable with whatever the value I want to calculate, for example 4. So 4, and then I just write here the call here the function that will calculate the factorial, and I just pass here as an argument, for example this will be replaced by 4. So factorial 4 will be n will be x will be replaced by 4, and this will call this function. Okay, so this will call this function, this will call this function, this will call this function. Okay, and the int n will be replaced by n is equal to 4. So it this function will receive 4 as an argument, and now n will be initialized. That is a temporary variable, okay, or dummy variable. So n will be initialized with 4. So now first of all the body will be executed. So whatever the code will be written in this body, this will be executed. So first of all it will check the condition n is equal to 1. So this is condition is 4. Okay, because 4 is not is equal to 1, so it means that the if condition will not be executed. So what will be executed will be that will be else part. So whatever the code will be written in else part will be executed. So I just write here the statement, the body in the statement in the body of the else is returned, and multiply by again calling that function with a different argument, that is n minus 1. As I've already explained you that if I want to calculate the factorial of 4, then I just have to write here 4 multiplied by 4 minus 1. So this is same like that. Okay, 4, this is will be replaced by 4 multiplied by factorial 4 minus 1. Okay, and this will call this function again but different with different argument. Okay, so this will again call a different this function again, but for our convenience I will write here I will write here in different box. Okay, so let's suppose this will call this function again, but this time the n will be replaced by 3. So first of all the condition will be checked that n is equal to 1. So what is the value stored in n is 3. So 3 is not is equal to 1, so condition is false. So it means again the else part will be executed. So what I have written in else part is n multiplied by factorial n minus 1. So this time n will be replaced by 3, and 3 multiplied by factorial 3 minus 1. So again this function will call the factorial function with different arguments, that will be 2. So n will be replaced by 2 this time, and again the if the base condition will be checked, that is n is equal to 1. So n will be replaced by 2, so condition is again false, and this if pulse that this if part will not be executed and else part will be executed. So I have written in this again that n multiply by factorial n minus 1, so 2 minus 1, and 2 minus 1 is of course 1. So 1 will be passed as the argument, and this time n will be replaced by 1, and n will be initialized with 1. Now when it will compiler will check that what is the what is written in this if condition, so it will check that 1 is equal to 1, so it means that condition is true and we have reached successfully the base condition. So when this condition is true, so it means that else part will not be executed further anymore, and whatever the lines statements will be written in if body will be executed. So only one statement is written, that is return 1. So it means that end this function and just return the value 1 to the point where the function was called. So this was the point where the function was called, and this whole value this will be replaced by 1. Okay, so this function will return 1 as if condition is true. So if body will execute, and 1 will be when will be returned to the point where the function was called. So now 1 will be returned, and this the function will be you can say deleted, eliminated from the main memory. Okay, so 2 multiplied by 1 also is equal to this function will now return 2. So because 2 multiplied by 1 is 2, so return 2 is means that return the 2 to the point where the function was called. So this is the point where the function was called. So 2 will be so this fact 3 minus 1 will be replaced by 2, and 3 multiply again this function will also be eliminated from the main memory, and 3 multiplied by 2 is equal to 6. So 6 will be returned to this point where the function was called. So this will function will now return 6. So this function will now return 6, and this function will again be eliminated from the main memory, and now the value is 4 multiplied by 6. So return 4 multiplied by 6 means 24. So 24 will be returned to the point where this function was called. So what where we called this function, actually we called this function in the main function, that is fact 4. Okay, so 24. So 24 will be returned to the point where the function was called. So this was that point. So this fact 4 will be replaced by 24. Okay. And they but will be printed on screen. So this function will also be like this, will be remain same. But now the in main and now on the console, because of this cout statement on console, this statement will be printed like factorial of 4 is 24. 24 was returned by this function. Okay, after calling this function and whatever the proceeding I have already explained you. So this function will calculate the factorial, and this will return the factorial of that number, and that number and the statement will be printed on screen, that is factorial of 4 is 24. So this was the function I have explained you, that this is the function. This will receive just the value whatever I want to calculate the factorial. For example, if I want to calculate the factorial of 4, then n will be replaced by 4. For example, if I want to calculate factorial of 5, then this n will be replaced by 5. So I just have to pass that value in this function, and it will return that the factorial of that number, okay, to the point where the function was called. That's why this return type is integer. And this also is integer because it is receiving an integer. Okay, one important thing is that the time complexity of this code is on, because we are traversing. For example, if I want to calculate a factorial of 4, then 4 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 1. So it means I am traversing the whole number 1 2 3 4 four times. I have traversed through this number. So it means the time complexity of this code is on. So space complexity of this function is finding the factorial is on. Why this is on? Because we just need a temporary variable or a dummy variable to find the factorial. So this will be so that's why the space complexity of this function is big O 1. Okay, that means constant complexity. Okay, so let's run and check the code on the editor. Okay, so this is my online editor. I am using online editor. You can use any type of editor like dev or visual code, visual blocks, atom, okay, and code blocks, and any type of editor. The code will be same, but the means the concept will be same, the code will be same. Just you can use this code in any type of editor. So this is dark mode, time this light mode, so that you can understand it. Okay, so this is the function. Okay, so this is the function I have already explained you in my slides. Okay, so this is the function that will calculate the factorial. Okay, and this is the main function that in the main function you can also take the input from the user, and this is the statement. Okay, and this will call this function, that is factorial x, that I've already explained you. Okay, so this is let's run this code. Okay, so let's run and you can just and let's see what will be the output of this function. Okay, so I have already explained you factorial of 4 is 4. Okay, so you can see on the console that it is printing that factorial of 4 is 24. For example, if I want to calculate the factorial of 5, so let's run this code. Okay, factorial of 5 is 120. So this is how this function will work. One important thing is, which I missed in the slides, is that for example, if I want to calculate the factorial of 0, so there is no condition for 0, but we know that factorial of 0 is 1. Okay, but then when this function will receive this, the function will receive 0 and n will be initialized with 0, then there is no condition, means 0 is not is equal to 1, and this will call again and again, and segmentation fault can occur. So to rectify it, we can also write here code n is equal to 0. So what it means that if n is equal to 0, then it also means that we have successfully reached our base condition, and we can just return 1. Okay, so now if I want to calculate the factorial of 0, then this will print that factorial of 0 is 1. Okay, so that's why I have written in this slide. But this will be only when you want to calculate the factorial of 0. So you can see on the console factorial of 0 is 1. Okay, so that's why this is function. I will also put the link in the description of this code from where you can also access this code. You can just copy this code and you can paste it on your editor to for better understanding. Okay, so this if you are confusing with this condition, so don't worry. This condition is only one for if you want to calculate factorial using factorial of zero. If you don't want to find the factorial of zero, means in the ideal case, if you want to make the simple code, then you can use this code. Okay, but if you want to make this code for ideal, means that this means that this function will receive whatever the input from 0 to any number. Okay, and this will find the factorial of that number. So you can also write here n is equal to 0. Okay, so this is the base condition and this is how this function will work. For example, if I want to calculate the factorial of 7, then this will calculate the factorial of 7 and it will print the answer, that is 5040. Okay, so this is how this function will work. So if you find any ambiguity in this code, then you can also comment on this section. So thanks for watching this video.